Hello, my dear students. This is the first video of Chapter 19, Class 5, Social Studies. So, our chapter's name is the Indian Government. Okay, Chapter 19, chapter's name is the Indian Government. So, we already learned that in Class 4, the three levels of government. There are three levels of our government. That is, central government, state government, and the local self-government. And in very detail you learned about the local self-government in class 4. So today, that means in this chapter, we are going to learn about the central government and the state government. So already you learned that local self-government and the duties and functions and everything. So in this class, in this chapter, we are going to learn about the central government and the state government. So in our central government is responsible for the whole country, the whole India. Who is responsible? Our central government. And then we can say that it has its office in our capital, India's capital, that is in New Delhi. So at present, okay, we all know that India is divided. So many states are there, okay, divided in so many states. So each state has its own, have their own government, that is state government. But the central government is responsible for the whole nation. At present, 28 states are there and 9 union territories are there. So in very detail, we are going to learn about the central government. Okay, so in central government, one law-making body is there, that is known as Parliament. Okay, the law making body of the central government, that is Parliament. Parliament, it is a law making body. That means they are making new laws for our country and they are amending the laws. Amendment means, or amending means, amend means to change. Already they have made some laws. If suppose one change is needed for that particular law, so they will amend, they will change that law. Okay, so that is the law-making body of our government, that is Parliament. So in Parliament, there are two houses. Okay, two houses are there in our Parliament. The first one, Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha is the lower house of the Parliament. Okay, Lok Sabha is the lower house of the Parliament. The next one is Rajya Sabha. That is also known as the upper house. Upper house of the Parliament, that is Rajya Sabha. So you have to learn some points about this Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Suppose in your examinations also, one question can ask, differentiate between the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Okay, so first point, Lok Sabha is the lower house of the Parliament. So here, lot of members are there. So here, I can show you this thing. Okay. For the central government, three bodies are there, legislative, executive and judiciary. These are the three important parts of our central government. So here, legislature means they are making the laws for our country. That is Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. So in Rajya Sabha, okay, 250 members are there. Members are there. Okay, and then in Lok Sabha, 545 members are there. At present, 545 members are there in our Lok Sabha. Okay, so here the members are in the Lok Sabha. It is directly elected by the people of India. For all the people of India, we are electing the members of this Lok Sabha. So here Lok Sabha is also known as the lower house of the Parliament, and the members are elected by the people of India. That means all the people of India are electing this members of this Lok Sabha. But here we can see that in Rajya Sabha, that is the upper house of the Parliament, here the people are not directly elected by the, that means elected to the members. That means some members are elected, okay, by the state legislative assemblies. That means we learned that in state government also, one legislative body is there, Vidhan Sabha. State legislative assemblies are there. So their members are also there. That members are electing these Rajya Sabha members. Okay, and some people, that means some members are nominated by the President of India. okay, and some people, some members are elected by the state legislative assemblies, and some, our President of India can also nominate some members in the Rajya Sabha. Okay, so that means some people are there, they are very famous in lot of fields, that means sports, science, literature, social service. So that distinguished people are there in our country. That people, okay, our president can nominate that kind of people in the Rajya Sabha. Okay, so both in this Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, the members are known as members of parliament. Both in the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, the members are there, people are there. So that members are known as the members of parliament, MPs, that we all know, MPs, isn't it? Yes. And then, so only this much is there about our parliament. Parliament is the lawmaking body of our government. So two houses are there in this parliament, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Okay, in the Lok Sabha, 250 seats are there, and in Rajya Sabha, 545 seats are there. Okay, and then the people, the members are elected by the people of India in the Lok Sabha. People are electing the members of this Lok Sabha. But in Rajya Sabha, some members are elected by the state legislative assemblies, and some are nominated by the President of India. Okay, and they will meet regularly. Okay, in the houses, these members will meet regularly in the parliament to amend the laws or to make new laws for our country. So that is about our parliament. So now we have to learn about the President of India. Okay, our head of the government. Government of India. President is the head of the government of India. And then how the president is elected. Okay, how we are electing the president of our country. So he is elected by the members of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the state legislative assemblies. So okay, so we are electing the members in the Lok Sabha. That members are there, and then Rajya Sabha also members are there, and then in every state legislative assemblies members are there. So they will elect the President of India. Okay, who is electing the President of India? Elected by the members of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the state legislative assemblies. That members also will elect them. So these members are electing our President of India. And then so he will do, he or she, okay, will do all the things, okay, what all the things is needed in our country on the advice of our Prime Minister and Prime Minister's Council of Ministers. So Prime Minister is there, and Cabinet Ministers are also there under our Prime Minister. So on the advice of that Prime Minister and the Council members, Council of Members or Council of Cabinet Ministers are there. So then our President of India, the President of India will do all those things. And our President, okay, President of India is the Supreme Commander of the Defence Forces. So in our country, Defence Force is there. Okay, three defense forces are there. That is our Army, Navy and Air Force. So for all these three defense forces, the President will be the Supreme Commander. Okay, President is the Supreme Commander of all these defense forces. So that is the points we have to learn about President. President is the head of the government of India, and he is elected by the members of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the members of the state legislative assemblies. And then he is the supreme commander of our defense forces. Okay, so next leader we are going to learn about, that is our Prime Minister. Okay, Prime Minister, that you all know that who is our current Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi. So Prime Minister is the real head of the Indian government. Okay, the head of the government is, government of India is President, but the real head of the Indian government is our Prime Minister. Okay, and then we all know that in every 5 years, okay, election will happen, and then after the election, you all know that one party will win the election, and then that majority party, okay, the majority party will be there in the Lok Sabha. The president will appoint the leader of that majority party, and he will become the prime minister of our country. Okay, that is the procedure. Okay, and then president appoints the leader of the majority party. So our president will appoint the leader of the majority party in the Lok Sabha, and he will become the prime minister of our country. Okay, after the election, we all know that the majority party leader will be there, and the president will appoint that person to our prime minister. That means prime minister of our country, and he is the real head of the Indian government. Okay, and then to support or to help our prime minister, there are a lot of departments are there, cabinet ministers are there. Okay, and for each department, one particular minister will be there, and to help that minister, sub ministers are also there in every department. Our for our defense and our health department, finance, and then home affairs. For every department, one minister is there, and to help that cabinet minister, other ministers are also there. So that is the whole our government, that we can say that prime minister and cabinet ministers are there to help the prime minister. Cabinet ministers are there, and in our country, for smooth working of the executive body and the legislative body and all these things, different departments are there, like our defense department, home affairs department, health department. So in every department, one particular cabinet minister is there, and to help that particular cabinet minister, there are a lot of other sub ministers are also there in our country. So that is about our prime minister. Prime minister is the real head of the Indian government, and president appoints the leader of the majority party. So after the election, the majority party will be there. So their leader, that leader will become the prime minister of our country, and he is the real head of the Indian government. So that is only about our prime minister. So I hope you all understood this topic about our parliament, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and president and prime minister. So we will meet in the next video, students. Thank you.